Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. And in this video, I'm going to provide you with a high-level overview of one of the most important financial statements, the balance sheet. We'll start off by answering the question to, what is a balance sheet? Next, we'll get an understanding of the key elements of this financial statement, and finally, go through a high-level example of how to prepare it. Whether you're looking to be a manager in a business, start your own company, or even become an investor, a general understanding of the balance sheet preparation process will arm you with the tools you need to be successful. Have you ever had a medical test done and received a report with the results? Reading through the report would have provided you with crucial information about your personal health. We can think of the balance sheet in the same way in relation to a business. It's a report that communicates important results about the financial health of an organization. The balance sheet can answer questions such as, how much cash does the company currently have? What's the value of the company's equipment? Or how much debt has the company taken on? The balance sheet is one of the most important financial reports. However, at times it can get complicated and time-consuming to prepare and understand. So let's clear up some of the confusion and give you an understanding of the purpose of the balance sheet and how it's prepared. Imagine you're a venture capital firm, and a company comes knocking on your door looking for you to invest in their organization. You likely wouldn't just hand them the cash, but instead would be looking to get an understanding of the business and want to make an assessment of their financial health. Think to yourself what type of information you would want to consider before handing them over the investment. You'd probably want to get an understanding of the company's valuation by looking at the value of the company's assets that they own and how much debt they currently have. It could take months to sift through a company's financial records. This is where the balance sheet comes in. The majority of companies prepare a balance sheet at the end of every accounting period to communicate financial information to their financial statement users. This allows a variety of stakeholders, such as company management, creditors, customers, and the government, to look under the hood of the company's operations and make important business decisions. Now that we understand more about the purpose of the balance sheet, let's dive into some of the details. You can think of the balance sheet as a snapshot of a moment in time that gives us an overview of an organization's financial health, broken down into assets, liabilities, and owner's equity. Assets are the resources the organization owns, such as cash, land, and equipment. Liabilities are debts that the organization has taken on, such as bank loans, wages owed to employees, or debts owed to suppliers. In a perfect world at any given time, a company would be able to cover all their liabilities with the assets that they own. The last category is owner's equity, which is the value that remains with the owners, including investment that comes into the company and earnings generated over time. On the balance sheet, the value of the company's assets must always equal the value of the company's liabilities plus their owner's equity. This is where the term balance sheet comes from, since it must always remain in balance. From looking at a company's balance sheet, we can quickly get an understanding of whether a company's struggling or thriving, in addition to determining the company's value to shareholders and investors. Now that we have a good understanding of the balance sheet, let's talk about a common misconception. While the balance sheet provides extremely valuable information to users of the financial statements, one thing it does not do is tell us about the profitability for a particular accounting period. Like we discussed, a balance sheet gives us a snapshot on a particular date and time. However, for example, if I wanted to find out how profitable a company was for the whole month of January, it would be difficult to tell from looking at the balance sheet alone. In this case, I would be better off analyzing a company's income statement, which breaks down the details of a company's revenue, expenses, and profit. Another common misconception is that the balance sheet tells us the valuation of a company. Now, while it can definitely be used to come up with a valuation, the numbers on the balance sheet alone are generally not enough. This is because many of the accounting numbers are prepared based on the historical cost of the item and do not necessarily take into account the fair market value that could be obtained if the company were to be sold today. Keeping all this in mind, let's look at an example of how to prepare a basic balance sheet. To start off, the balance sheet always lists the name of the company and date at the top. Individual accounts are grouped below by account type, with assets listed on the top half and liabilities and owner's equity on the bottom half of the statement. In this example, we can see all of the company's assets are grouped together, things like the value of their cash, inventory, and property, plant, and equipment. they're further separated into current or long-term, based on the nature of the asset. Assets that they're planning to convert into cash within 1 year's time are current assets, and assets that they plan to hold onto for longer than a year would be considered long-term. On the bottom half of the balance sheet, the company lists out all their liabilities and owner's equity. For liabilities, companies must report their financial commitments, things like the money they owe their suppliers, taxes payable, and their long-term debt balances. For the owner's equity section, the company would report any investment that has come into the organization by shareholders and the accumulative amount of earnings that remain in the company. There is a dual effect of transactions that keep things in balance at all times. This means that any transaction that impacts the asset side of the equation will have an equal impact to the liabilities and equity side. This keeps things in balance, like we can see here on this balance sheet. The total asset value of $58,000 equals the total liabilities and owner's equity value below. Time for a quick recap. The balance sheet provides users with critical information about a company's performance. It gives us a clear snapshot of the company's overall financial health at a given point in time. Whether you're a business owner, employee, or investor, understanding how to read and make decisions from the information in this financial statement is a critical skill in today's business world. Now, while we just skimmed the surface here in this video, if you're interested in learning more, please feel free to check out our additional videos where we dive even deeper into each of these financial statements.